So this process, okay, this process, whenever the both are reaching the equal concentration, okay, so that it is called as the chemical equilibrium. Okay, now this chemical equilibrium is considered as a dynamic equilibrium. What it is called as here? The dynamic equilibrium. The rate of forward reaction is always equal to the rate of backward reaction. That is also called as here the dynamic equilibrium. Okay, so it is the information about the chemical equilibrium. It is also called as dynamic equilibrium. I am giving the graph between the time and concentration. I am giving the graph between which one here? Time and concentration. Concentration on y-axis, time on x-axis. So whenever the time is going on, so whenever the time is increases, the concentration of the reactants on here the decreases. Next of all, the concentration of product should be increases. Okay, it is called as dynamic equilibrium. This dynamic equilibrium is also applicable for the Haber's process, ammonia preparation, and it is also applicable for the hydrogen iodide preparation. Hydrogen iodide preparation. For the hydrogen iodide preparation, I want to take here the two types of the graphs. That means for forward reaction I want to explain, and as well as for backward reaction also. For example, H2 plus I2, it will give twice here the HI. Okay, so same graph I am taking here the both manners, to the forward reaction and as well as here the to the backward reaction. So as it is here the for the forward reaction, it is the forward reaction, it should be belongs to here the forward reaction. So for the forward reaction, decrease in the concentration, decrease in the concentration, and here I can take the time. Next of all, increase in the concentration. Okay, that means the concentration of H2 and I2 will be decreases, and the concentration of HI here should be the increases. Okay, it is the one kind of equilibrium. Okay, for which reaction? It is the forward reaction. So whenever you are taking here the for backward reaction, so here the backward reaction, actually HI is nothing but hydrogen iodide possesses highest concentration, and it is always decreases. Okay, and the hydrogen iodide concentration, it should be here always. Okay, I can draw neatly. Okay, listen. So here the concentration of hydrogen iodide is increased in the forward reaction, and as well as decreased in the backward reaction. And here the hydrogen iodide concentration is decreased in the forward reaction, and hydrogen iodide H2ID, that should be concentration increases. Okay, so these are here the H2 and I2, and these are it is nothing but HI. Okay, it is for the backward reaction, it is for the forward reaction. Which one here? It is the backward reaction and it is here the forward reaction. Okay, so actually the graph should be like this. Okay, it is the real graph. It is our real graph. This place is considered as here the equilibrium place. What it is called as here? The equilibrium place. Middle of the place is equilibrium place. This is the decrease in the concentration, increase in the concentration, increase in the concentration, decrease in the concentration. Okay, it is the dynamic equilibrium representation for the hydrogen iodide formation. Okay, so it is the theoretical part which is present in the chemical equilibrium. Okay, so now I want to explain chemical equilibrium law. Okay, next topic, what it is here? The chemical equilibrium, chemical equilibrium law, or chemical equilibrium constant. Chemical equilibrium constant. Okay, so for the explanation of chemical equilibrium law or chemical equilibrium constant, first of all I want to explain the definition. Okay, so here the definition. at any temperature, at any temperature, the ratio between the ratio between the product of molar concentrations, molar concentration of products to the product of molar concentration of reactants with each concentration raised to power equal to stoichiometric coefficient, not balancing coefficients in balanced chemical equation is called as a chemical equilibrium law or chemical equilibrium constant. Now I want to explain each and one word. First word, what it is here? At any temperature. Already I told equilibrium always depends upon which one? Temperature. So that's why I'm using the word at any temperature. Next word, what it is here? The ratio between the product of molar concentrations of products. Okay, so that means whenever you are taking here one of the chemical equation, A plus B gives Y here, C plus D. These are here the products. Okay, these are here the reactants. Now, the ratio of which one here? The product of molar concentrations of products. These are the products. To the which one here? The product of molar concentration of reactants is called as normally chemical equilibrium law or chemical equilibrium constant. But here also I am using the word each concentration raised to power. If these are having any concentration, it can have the concentration small a, it can have the concentration small b, it has the concentration c, and it can have here the concentration d. So these concentration terminologies are, okay, you have to indicate it with which one here the power of which one here the stoichiometric coefficient. These are considered now here the stoichiometric coefficient, and compulsory that chemical equation should be here the balanced. That chemical equation compulsory here the balanced. Now that should be called as chemical equilibrium law or chemical equilibrium constant. Okay, chemical equilibrium constant is always represented with K.